Hello, welcome to the 1000 day challenge. This is day 522. So let's get things started. All right, so first and foremost, in terms of equity wise, it's remained the same. I have no change in terms of my entry and exit, even for experimental trade setup. I did close one trade for Luna itself with a near break even price itself. I'll update this after this. So just a plus minus a dollar or two. All right. Otherwise, if you look in terms of a general market structure itself on US market right now, it looks to remain bullish. In fact, yesterday I thought we could have a very nice pullback, but actually we actually continue towards the upside of things. So that is why it is really hard to say for certain where we'll be heading. You can see an indecision and we seem to be bouncing towards the upside. And on the chart, it looks to be really fine as well. So not to say that we will likely just continue the momentum towards the upside, which is a little bit dangerous. So for me, we do consolidate over here. It's actually a very nice move and a good move itself as it forms a very nice base for push towards the upside. And what we form over here to push towards the upside kind of things. All right, so things looks to be really bullish. And if you look in terms of NASDAQ itself, same thing. We are very much near the all-time high region itself over here. And the daily support region itself, you can see over here, form very nice teachers as well. So basically over here, we can see very nice support resistance and maintaining over here is definitely a good sign. And if we do trend towards the upside, we have these upslope kind of key resistances that will be taken note of. And there's acting with respect to time as well, because this upslope trend line, do bear in mind that this trend line definitely do move towards the upside over a period of time. So bear in mind that what I mentioned, upslope or downslope trend line is something that I always look for secondary, meaning to say primary resistance and support is still look for horizontally speaking, simply because there is more objective, whereas subjectively you have this now strong upstroke trend line, which could vary significantly depending on how you draw it, and both in terms of angles wise and also in terms of do you take into consideration a week or which peak to which peak in that sense, and also whether you use a log chart or a normal chart kind of basis. So because of the variety that you can have, the different perspective that you can have is more subjective in that sense. And also for if you're looking for pure the technical kind of basis, that will form a kind of a subjective basis, which I'm a little bit less reliant on it. All right, so with that said, otherwise, China market, something to bear in mind that Asia China looks to be really choppy, hovering around here, nothing to be much of concern about. What I'm concerned about is actually KWEB itself. So even though we have a very nice bounce, it doesn't seem to have a flow through itself, and volume still seems to be of high interest with some sell-off pressure, but it doesn't seem to be pushing much further towards the downside. So it goes to show that it's buying, at least buying support at this region itself. So even with sellers selling in, it's not exactly dropping as much as it should. So yeah, so hopefully we can actually bounce up strongly above within the next couple of days or latest by end of next week itself, because if we do stay over here for extended period of time, then I will lean to somewhat further bearish momentum than what we form over here. So definitely not what we want to see. All right, so otherwise in terms of Bitcoin wise, I still lean towards a slow potential bearish momentum. You can see we're coming very nicely below the key previous support and downturn resistance itself. So this sell stop order still remain in place, and it will be triggered when the price go below 45.54k region itself. So target will definitely be here near the 40.8k region itself, in which case then we could see a much sharper drop itself. Yep. So yeah, but bear in mind that the overall crypto market itself looks rather flat. It's not as bearish as Bitcoin actually, which is quite surprising because generally Bitcoin does tend to take the lead, but it seems that this is flipping the other side. But we do see the potential of a very strong push towards the upside or downside. Reason being, you can see that as we trend towards the downside, the volume is actually dwindling, which is a very clear sign of consolidation. And consolidation or tightening of volatility in terms of price action wise also leads to a very strong breakout thereafter. So the question is, which side would it break? Of course, tentatively right now, we do lean towards the down side of things simply because we are accumulating right below resistance itself. But what Bitcoin does have is that Bitcoin can always be unpredictable, and technical chart is always something that we do mention that one thing for certain is that tightening volatility will lead to a breakout, but that doesn't necessarily mean there is a breakout towards the upside or the downside. Whereas of this moment itself, I will lean towards the downside simply because of where it is accumulating itself and where it's coming from. All right, otherwise, that's more or less about it. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop by your comments below. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.